Oh, yes, hello. Welcome to what will probably be the final episode of Stu Bakes for You. Ah, yes, sad wee wee. Oh, yes. My name for now is Stuart Fournier, and today we will be making braided marble rye sandwich bread. Yummy, yes, yes, okay, hurry. For this bread, we will be making two different doughs, the light and the dark, and braiding them.
As fast as you can, gather the ingredients.
No, I don't have time for this. Come on.
You will need 3 cups of bread flour, 1.5 cups of rye flour, 1.5 teaspoons of caraway seeds, 1.5 teaspoon salt, 1.5 tablespoon molasses, 1.5 tablespoon honey, 1 package of instant yeast, 1 tablespoon cocoa powder, 2 tablespoons softened butter, and 1.3 cups of water. Both of the doughs will have the same ingredients and measurements with the exception of the honey, molasses, and cocoa powder. You have it all? Okay, good. Now let's go.
Okay, okay. Combine half the rye flour, half the bread flour, half the salt, half the yeast, half the caraway seeds, half the butter, half the water, and all of the honey. Mix on low with dough hook or spoon until the dough comes together. Switch to medium-low and mix for about 5 minutes until smooth. Transfer the dough to an oiled bowl and cover with plastic wrap.
Okay, keep in mind we need to go as quickly as possible. Now on to the second dough!
Combine half the rye flour, half the bread flour, half the salt, half the yeast, half the caraway seeds, all of the molasses, half the butter, and half of the water. Dissolve the cocoa powder in 1/2 ounce water and add to bowl.
Hurry now!
Mix on low with dough hook or with spoon until the dough comes together. Switch to medium-low and mix for about 5 minutes until smooth. Transfer the dough to an oiled bowl and cover with plastic wrap. Oh, thank God, they are done.
Oof. Now let them rest for 60 to 90 minutes until doubled.
Time to face Lady Justice.
Okay, 90 minutes. These look doubled.
Divide each dough in half and roll each piece into a 12-inch rope. Line the strands up, alternating colors, and pinch the end together. Fold strand 4 over strand 2. Then fold strand 1 over strand 3. Finally fold strand 2 over strand 3. Repeat this process until out of dough. Pinch the ends together and tuck under the loaf. Put it in a greased bread pan and cover with oiled plastic wrap.
Oof, glad that is over with. Now let it rise 60 to 90 minutes until almost doubled.
At some point, preheat the oven to 350 degrees while it's rising.
I'm only a few days away from retirement. It's not worth it.
Okay, dough's risen.
Put them in the oven 45 minutes until they reach 190 degrees.
Oh, I need to pack underwear.
Oh wait, do I?
All right, time's up, Stu. You're coming. I feel like maybe the last part of my soul died that day. I put everything into that case, and like everything else, it was for nothing. Not a day goes by that I don't think I see Stuart somewhere, at a restaurant, hailing a cab, in the bushes. But I know deep down it's not him. He's long gone, and with him went my purpose.
Listen, our blood is blue. We have blue blood.
I spent my last small amount of days on the force and got the hell out of there. I finally retired to that beach, but it doesn't feel right, like I didn't earn it. Stu took that from me. I do know that if I ever run into him again, I'm gonna beat him up.
Excuse me, where's the ship heading again?
Yar, to the Gulf of Mexico, ending up in Port Mobile, Alabama. We're going to the deep south.
Just as good even.